Blackstone Audio presents Ulysses by James Joyce. Chapter 1. Stately, plump Buck Mulligan came from the stairhead, bearing a bowl of lather on which a mirror and a razor lay crossed. A yellow dressing gown, ungirdled, was sustained gently behind him on the mild morning air. He held the bowl aloft and intoned, "Introibo ad altare dei." Halted, he peered down the dark winding stairs and called out coarsely, "Come up, Kinch, come up, you fearful Jesuit." Solemnly he came forward and mounted the round gunrest. He faced about and blessed gravely thrice the tower, the surrounding land, and the awaking mountains. Then, catching sight of Stephen Dedalus, he bent towards him and made rapid crosses in the air, gurgling in his throat and shaking his head. Stephen Dedalus, displeased and sleepy, leaned his arms on the top of the staircase and looked coldly at the shaking, gurgling face that blessed him, equine in its length, and at the light, untonsured hair, grained and hued like pale oak. Buck Mulligan peeped an instant under the mirror and then covered the bowl smartly. "Back to barracks," he said sternly. He added in a preacher's tone, "For this, O dearly beloved, is the genuine Christine. Body and soul and blood and oons. Slow music, please. Shut your eyes, gents. One moment. A little trouble about those white corpuscles. Silence all." He peered sideways up and gave a long, slow whistle of call, then paused a while in rapt attention, his even white teeth glistening here and there with gold points. Chrysostomus. Two strong, shrill whistles answered through the calm. "Thanks, old chap," he cried briskly. "That will do nicely. Switch off the current, will you?" He skipped off the gunrest and looked gravely at his watcher, gathering about his legs the loose folds of his gown. The plump, shadowed face and sullen oval jowl recalled a prelate, patron of arts in the Middle Ages. A pleasant smile broke quietly over his lips. "The mockery of it," he said gaily. "Your absurd name, an ancient Greek." He pointed his finger in friendly jest and went over to the parapet, laughing to himself. Stephen Dedalus stepped up, followed him wearily halfway, and sat down on the edge of the gunrest, watching him still as he propped his mirror on the parapet, dipped the brush in the bowl, and lathered cheeks and neck. Buck Mulligan's gay voice went on, "My name is absurd too. Malachy Mulligan. Two dactyls. But it has a Hellenic ring, hasn't it? Tripping and sunny like the buck himself. We must go to Athens. Will you come if I can get the aunt to fork out 20 quid? He laid the brush aside and, laughing with delight, cried, "Will he come, the jejune Jesuit?" Ceasing, he began to shave with care. "Tell me, Mulligan," Stephen said quietly. "Yes, my love. How long is Haynes going to stay in this tower?" Buck Mulligan showed a shaven cheek over his right shoulder. "God, isn't he dreadful?" he said frankly. "A ponderous Saxon. He thinks you're not a gentleman. God, these bloody English. Bursting with money and indigestion. Because he comes from Oxford. You know, Dedalus, you have the real Oxford manner. He can't make you out. Oh, my name for you is the best. Kinch, the knife blade." He shaved warily over his chin. "He was raving all night about a black panther," Stephen said. "Where is his gun case?" "A woeful lunatic," Mulligan said. "Were you in a funk?" "I was," Stephen said with energy and growing fear. "Out here in the dark with a man I don't know, raving and moaning to himself about shooting a black panther." "You saved men from drowning. I'm not a hero, however. If he stays on here, I am off." Buck Mulligan frowned at the lather on his razor blade. He hopped down from his perch and began to search his trouser pockets hastily. "Scutter!" he cried thickly. He came over to the gunrest and, thrusting a hand into Stephen's upper pocket, said, "Lend us a loan of your nose rag to wipe my razor." Stephen suffered him to pull out and hold up on show by its corner a dirty crumpled handkerchief.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.